Welcome to the video lecture series of Theory of Computation. Today we are going to discuss about the relation. I'm your instructor Poonam Patel. Let's start to understand this concept. Our today's outline for this lecture is, first we have to discuss introduction about relation, and then next is properties of relation. Start with the introduction. Now, what is relation? So basically, suppose S is our set, and a binary relation is defined on the set which is always a subset of S cross S. Generally, a relation is defined as capital R. Okay, it is denoted by capital R. And here we can say that a relation is defined on a set S. It is always the subset of S cross S. And we can say that the relation is a collection of ordered pairs like x comma y, where we can say that x is related to y. We can define this pair likewise x r y, x capital R capital Y, and we can say that x is related to y. So we can say that these two ways are way to represent the pair. Okay, now let us understand this concept by using the example. Here I have taken two set. The first is A and second is B. 1, 2, 4 is element of A, and 1, 2, 8 is element of A, and 4, 5 is element of B. Now, first of all, I have performed the Cartesian operation on these two sides. In a previous video, we have already discussed about the Cartesian product. So, the same way I have defined the Cartesian product, I have calculated the Cartesian product. So, A cross B, where the element of A is connected with the element of B. So 1 comma 4, 1 comma 5, these two pairs are created. 2 comma 4, 2 comma 5, 8 comma 4, 8 comma 5. Now I want to define our relation on this A cross B, on these two sides. So I have a write down one statement, like R capital R equal to x comma y. It means that the pairs, we have to select those pairs which satisfy the condition. The condition is given like x greater than y, whereas x belongs to A and y belong to B. X belongs to A, it means that the first element is from A and the second element is from B. Now I want to pick up only those pair in A cross B which satisfy this condition, because it defines the relation between x and y. So if you see all pairs, 1 comma 4 is satisfy the condition? No. 1 comma 5? No. 2 comma 4 not satisfy the condition. 2 comma 5 not satisfy the condition. But 8 comma 4, 8 comma 5, both the pairs where the first element is greater than the second element. So we have to include these two pairs in the relation. So this is called the relation. Now move on to the next topic. Properties of relation. Properties of relation. So here we have discussed about the properties of relation on this set. We have taken the set A. The first property is reflexive. What this property said? So the relation is called the reflexive when it satisfies this condition. What condition? For all elements small a belongs to capital A, where A comma A is belongs to R. So it means that the first value would be copy value, second element would be the copy of first element, A comma A. And this all pairs, it must be for all elements of set. Now let us understand this property by using the example. Here I have taken the example. The relation is defined on the set A. Set A contains the element 1 comma 2. And relation is defined, relation contains the pairs 1 comma 1, 1 comma 2, 2 comma 1 and 2 comma 2. Now let me check whether the all elements of A has satisfied the condition. Yes, A comma A is available. So 1 comma 1 is available in a relation. Yes. The second value 2. So 2 comma 2 is available. Yes. So we can say that for all elements of A, A comma A pair is available in a given relation. So we can say that this relation is reflexive relation. Now move on the next property, which is called the symmetric. Now what property should be, what condition should be satisfy the property of symmetric? So we can say that those relation is symmetric if ARB implies BRA. If AB is available, then it must be BA is available. So we can say that the mirror image should be available. AB, so its mirror image is reverse BA. So let us understand this concept by using the example. So here you can see I have taken the same example. So the relation is defined on a set A 1, 2, and the relation is 1, relation contain the pairs 1, 1, 1, 2, 2, 1, 2, 2. Now we have to check every pair and check whether its mirror image is available or not. Now in this example, you can see 1, 1. What is mirror image? 1, 1, it is available in a relation. Now 1, 2, what it mirrors image? 2, 1. Now you have to check whether 2, 1 is available in relation or not. Yes, this relation is containing 2, 1. Now take the next pair, third pair, 2, 1. What its mirror image? 1, 2. Now check whether this relation is containing 1, 2. Yes, this relation is containing 1, 2. Now last pair we have to check, 2, 2. What its mirror image? It's 2, 2. So we have said that the this relation is satisfy the properties of symmetric. So this relation is symmetric. Now move on the third property, which is called the transitive property. Now what transitive property say? Transitive property say if ARB and BRC, if these two pairs is available, then it must be contained, implies that AC. Now we have to check those two pairs which have the common element. If you see in this condition AB, BC, so B is the common element and those pair is available, we have to find the third pair, whether this third pair is available or not. So let us understand this concept by using the example. Here I have defined the relation 1, 1, 1, 2, 2, 1, 2, 2 on the set 1, 2. Now we have to check whether this relation is transitive or not. So can we compare 1, 1, 1, 2? Two pair I have picked up, and let me check whether these two pair can we compare. Yes, this two pair containing one common element, in the first pair second element and second pair the first element, both are containing one as a common element, so we can compare these two pairs 1, 1, 1, 2. Now what third pair should contain this relation? 1, 2. So here you can see in this relation 1, 2 is available in this relation. Now move on the next pair. Now move on the next pair, 1, 2, 2, 2. Can we compare this pair? Yes, 1, 2 and 2, 2. So in the first pair second element and the second pair first element, both are common, so we can compare this pair. So what pair should be available? So 1, 1 should be available, 1, 2, 2, 1. So 1, 1 should be available. So you can see in this relation 1, 1 is available. Now can we compare this? Now the same way we have to compare all those pair which have in the first pair second element and the second pair first element is common. So in likewise you can compare this and we can say that this relation is satisfy the properties of transitive. So the given relation is transitive. Now what is equivalence relation? So equivalence relation, a relation is said to equivalence relation if any relation is having these three properties. The relation is reflexive, symmetric and transitive. If these three properties is satisfied, those relation, we can say that this relation is equivalence relation. Now move on the next one. Here the one question is given like this: check whether this given relation is reflexive or not, transitive or not and symmetric or not. The relation is given रिलेशन इज डिफाइंड ऑन द सेट ए ए कंटेनिंग 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 सिक्स एलिमेंट्स इट्स कंटेनिंग एंड द रिलेशन कंटेनिंग द पेयर्स 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4, 4 एंड 4, 5. नाउ आई हैव टू चेक वेदर दिस गिवन रिलेशन इज ट्रांजिटिव और नॉट, सिमेट्रिक और नॉट एंड रिफ्लेक्सिव और नॉट. नाउ स्टार्ट विद द रिफ्लेक्सिव. सो एज वी नो वट इज द रिफ्लेक्सिव प्रॉपर्टीज, सो वी कैन चेक ऑल द एलिमेंट्स ऑफ ए शुड हैव ए कॉमा ए इन रिलेशन. सो 1, 1 मस्ट बी अवेलेबल, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4 एंड 5, 5 एंड 6, 6. सो द फर्स्ट पेयर 1, 1 इज नॉट अवेलेबल इन आर. सो वी कैन डायरेक्टली राइट डाउन द स्टेटमेंट लाइक 1, 1 इज नॉट बिलोंग्स टू आर, दैट्स वाई दिस रिलेशन इज नॉट रिफ्लेक्सिव. कैन वी राइट डाउन फॉर ऑल द नॉट अवेलेबल पेयर? नो, वी डू नॉट नीड टू राइट डाउन ऑल पेयर्स फॉर द रिफ्लेक्सिव प्रॉपर्टीज. वी जस्ट राइट डाउन द वन पेयर विच इज नॉट अवेलेबल इन द रिलेशन. सो 1, 1 इज नॉट बिलोंग्स टू आर, सो इट इज नॉट रिफ्लेक्सिव. नाउ लेट मी चेक द सेकेंड प्रॉपर्टी, सिमेट्रिक. वट प्रॉपर्टी से ए कॉमा वी देन इट्स मिरर इमेज बी कॉमा ए मस्ट बी अवेलेबल. सो हियर यू कैन सी 1, 2 इज बिलोंग्स टू आर, यस. So what its mirror image should be in a relation? 2, 1. So let me check whether 2, 1 is available in this relation. No, 2, 1 is not available. So we can directly write down the statement 1, 2 is belongs to R, but not 2, 1 is belongs not belongs to R. So 2, 1 is not belongs to R. So it is not symmetric. 1, 2 is belongs to R, but 2, 1 is not belongs to R. Now move on the last properties, transitive. So for the transitive property, we have to pick up those pair which have the common elements. So here I have pick up two pairs, 1, 2, 2, 3, and let me verify whether this third pair is available or not. So 1, 2 is belongs to R and 2, 3 is belongs to R. Now what third pair should be available in relation? 1, 3. Okay, so 1, 3 is available in a relation? No, it is not available. So we can directly write down 1, 3 is not belongs to R. So that's why this relation is not transitive. Suppose I want to check whether this given relation is equivalence or not. So how would we can check whether this given relation is equivalent or not? So for the equivalency, as we have seen already in a previous slide, equivalence relation, the given relation is said to equivalence if the relation is reflexive, transitive and symmetric. So in this example, you can see this relation is not reflexive, not symmetric and not transitive. So we can say that the given relation is not equivalence relation. So I hope this concept is clear to you. Thank you all.